This is a story about a character who is confused to make a decision between being loyal with his brother and telling the truth. Jamie is an 18-year-old boy who is prestigious and mature, and is always bailing his older brother Ted out of trouble. Ted is Jamie's older brother, 21 years old, who is a very responsible football player, but he is immature and weak in real life. Carmody is the lawyer of the football team who tried to bail Ted out of the problem.
The story starts when one night Jamie was at home alone while Uncle Harry, who he lived with, went fishing, and Ted called him for help because he had a huge problem. After that, Ted came and followed his brother to the kitchen. He looked at Jamie's grim, straight back and didn't speak.
Jamie, I need you a lot.
Let's go into a kitchen and have a cup of coffee. You look like you could use one.
Whatever you say.
Then we will talk.
Anything you say.
What is this time? Tell me, Ted.
I hit a man.
Another ball fight? You were not a drinker. How can you get into this thing?
No, Jamie.
Then what?
I was driving on this main street, and I hit a man. He was drunk and walked in front of my car. It was really dark and nobody's around. You know how deserted that main street is. You know, Jamie, you know, it's the truth.
And?
I panicked and left him there.
What is the heck are you saying? What?
I panicked.
And you left him there? How? How could you do that?
I lost my head. It wasn't my fault. He walked in front of the car. He was drunk. I wasn't going fast. I wasn't. I swear to death and mom's grave that I...
And you leave him laying on the street?
There was nobody around. I wasn't myself. You know, I helped everybody. I got scared. It wasn't myself.
But he's a human being, not a dog. You don't even leave a dog on the street and run off.
It happened so fast. I couldn't do it, just couldn't.
Was he dead?
No, just her.
How do you know that?
I went back, walked, and there was an ambulance stairs. I stood where nobody could see me.
Why didn't you come out? Go over there and face it.
I just couldn't.
All you need to tell the truth.
Couldn't do it, just...
You are lost, Ted.
I spoke to Comedy.
Who is he?
The team's lawyer. He wants to talk to you.
To me? Why?
I don't know. I really don't know. I swear to you, almost.
Don't swear. Leave mom and dad out of it. Let them sleep in peace.
Jamie, please don't talk to me that way. Please don't do it.
You make me. I'm tired of you, Ted.
Please don't say that. Don't leave me alone. I can't make it without you.
When does Comedy want me to talk to him?
In the morning, anytime you choose.
Okay.
Thanks.
Go to bed and try to get some rest.
Sure, Jamie, sure.
In the Carmody's room, Ted claimed that nobody saw him.
But soon,
someone will come and told us that Ted hits a man. And based on my experience, it happens all the time. So we must get ready. So far, the police doesn't have any clues. I understand, Jamie, that you were being responsible in your studies.
I was.
And you're being accepted to a very prestigious college?
Jill, he's getting a full scholarship. I told you that.
You did, Ted. Your brother needs your help. Needs it badly.
What does he need?
For you to say that he was with you at that night when the accident happened.
You didn't tell me that Jenny would have to do that.
We have no choice.
But against all he stands for, I know him. I don't want it.
You'll do it as I tell you.
No, I will hold still for this.
You have to.
No, no.
Keep quiet and sit down. You listen to me. You're one of the youngest top pro football players today. You made $3 million for years. You will make much more than that. You are sure to become the club's most valuable property.
I lost my head. I lost it.
I know and I understand. But you're going to be called in the court. I'll put you through. You say you care for your brother.
Yes.
Then you must do this.
Must?
Yeah. I assure you that nothing will happen between you and your brother. Nothing.
You know from experience?
I know well, Jamie.
And you are thinking of some men who are in Asia.
I am. He will fully recover and then he's going to be quietly well taken care of. It will turn out to be the best thing that has ever happened to him. Let's wait and see what happens. But we can count on you.
You can count on me.
In the courtroom, Jamie raised his right hand and looked over to where Ted sat. Finally, he realized this is the time that he must tell the truth. And he also knew that he could never again be his brother's keeper. Little girls depend on things like that. Brush my teeth and comb my hair. Had to drive me everywhere. You were always there when I looked back. You had to do it all alone. Make a living, make a home. It must have been as hard as it could have been.
I've been a lawyer for a long, long time. So we must get ready. So far, police doesn't have any clues. Not one. I understand that you were bullied because of someday. But soon, someone will come and told us that Ted hits a man. And based on my experience, they always happen. It always happens all the time.
No, no. Keep quiet and sit down. You listen to me.
You're a football player. You're a pro in football. You're making hella money. Oh, I said hella money.
No, no.
Keep quiet and sit down. Listen, why you're laughing?
No, no.
Keep quiet and sit down. You have to listen to me. You're making hella money. Ah!
No, no.
But you're going to be called in the court. Mark my words.
Wait!
Yeah, I changed it.
No, no.
Keep quiet and sit down.
Thank you.
out to be the best thing that has ever happened to you. Let's wait and see what happens. But we can count on you.
You can count on me.
You can count on me.